This couple come together in the eyes of God above, and let nobody tear asunder what is witness blessed with love. Deep within the cavern, a spirit still lives free. If anyone has anything, just cause or impediment, say it now or hold your peace forever to your detriment. I will not let it happen. I will not let it be. For this man is not what he appears to be. Taught to trust the scriptures, what I've seen belies my faith. Fire and water, blood and thunder, ghosts and demons, ghouls and wraiths. I could not let it happen. Let evil pass me by.
This is North Derbyshire Radio News at 4 p.m. on Saturday, September the 5th. There were dramatic events today at Poole's Cavern in Buxton, where a planned wedding ceremony was disrupted by apparently supernatural forces. A gatecrasher, believed to be a Mr. Solomon of Leek, Staffordshire, and claiming to be a warlock, accused the would-be groom of being a reincarnation of Arthur Poole, the 14th century outlaw who gave his name to the tourist attraction on the outskirts of the town. The ceremony was finally cancelled when the aforementioned groom, a Mr. Paul Rotherow from Perth, Australia, physically attacked Mr. Solomon. Witness reports that Mr. Rotherow was spitting fire and spontaneously growing additional limbs could not be substantiated at the time of broadcast. It can be confirmed that Mr. Rotherow subsequently collapsed and is currently in a coma, under medical supervision and police guard. Mr. Solomon, meantime, was at pains to point out that the name Paul Rotherow is itself an anagram of the name Arthur Poole.
Hello, Diane. Are you there?
James, I'm so sorry. Can you ever forgive me for what's happened? I mean, the last 6 months, Paul, the engagement. I can't begin to explain and you'll never believe...
Diane, stop. It's all right. I understand. I know everything. I had spoken to Solomon before the wedding.
So, did you know this guy, Solomon?
No, like I say, I just spoke to him once on the phone. He's a warlock. He explained what was going on. This evil spirit using incarnations of Poole to enslave women. I didn't believe it at first, and then, when I considered all the things that have happened, I reckon Rothero, or rather Poole, must have killed Jackson, and he must have planted that cocaine. And I know now that he had you under some kind of spell. Well, I assume so. I hope so. I mean, you do still want to be with me, don't you?
Honestly, James, I can't wait to see you. I love you, James.
I love you, Diane. It's going to be so good to have you back.
This is North Derbyshire Radio News at 8 p.m. on Saturday, September the 5th, 1981. Buxton Police have this evening announced that a Mr. Poole Rothero, who was being held on suspicion of assault, has escaped in what they are calling extremely mysterious circumstances. DCI Thompson of Buxton Police spoke at a press conference earlier.
I can confirm that a Mr. Poole Rothero, who was detained earlier today for assaulting a guest at his wedding, has, to all intents and purposes, disappeared. I can assure you Mr. Rothero was in a locked cell, alone, and at the last sighting was, as he had been for the previous few hours, in a completely comatose condition. Buxton Police are at a complete loss to explain how this has happened. I will not be taking any questions this evening, ladies and gentlemen, because, quite frankly, I don't have any answers.